So, and then when you get the pancreas, you can store an image of the pancreas. Yeah, you can.
Oh, okay.
I don't know, is that really necessary?
No, it's
you don't
not.
have to
You
do
don't
that.
have to annotate. Just be sure to take the picture, yeah.
All right, so name two things you might be looking for in the pancreas with a patient who has abdominal pain.
Pancreatitis or pancreatic head mass.
Okay, and anything else?
A dilated pancreatic duct.
Okay, and what structure courses along the posterior wall of the body and tail of the pancreas?
The spleen.
And could you give me a waveform of that vessel, please, and then store that image? Direction is that going?
Towards the liver.
Okay, and is that what you expect in a normal patient?
Yes.
Okay. Name two symptoms your patient might have if they have acute pancreatitis.
Two symptoms?
Yes.
Nausea and vomiting, and abdominal pain.
Okay. Now we're going to switch over to the liver. So I want you to take a store an image of the hepatic veins, please. Get the hepatic vein picture and you can store an image. Okay, and then what conditions should be ruled out concerning the hepatic veins?
Blood clearing.
And what is that?
It's when the hepatic veins are not patent and they have thrombosis.
Okay. Now, what disease process other than fatty liver can lead to liver enlargement?
Hepatitis and cirrhosis in early stages.
Okay. Show me a sagittal image of the right lobe of the liver and include the dome of the liver. And then you can store that.
Take a big deep breath in and hold it.
Store that, okay. And then what three sonographic findings would you evaluate in a patient who has cirrhosis?
The main portal vein, the sonographic findings.
Sonographic findings of cirrhosis, yeah.
A large caudate and left lobe nodularity in echogenic and late stages.
Okay. And beyond the echo texture and size of the liver, what other process are you looking for with cirrhosis?
Splenomegaly,
and then that's kind of secondary to a process in the liver that starts in the liver, and what is that?
Portal hypertension.
Portal hypertension, okay, and what else do you see with portal hypertension? What other sonographic findings?
I've had a fugal flow.
Okay.
And cavernous transformation and a patent on para-umbilical vein.
Okay, and then you mentioned splenomegaly, okay. What exactly is cavernous transformation?
Those are collaterals that form around the main portal vein.
Let's look at the gallbladder. So store a sagittal image of the gallbladder, please. You can store that, and then what are you looking for with a patient with symptoms of abdominal pain and regarding the gallbladder, what are you evaluating for?
Cholecystitis.
Okay, and give us three sonographic findings of that.
Pericholecystic fluid, a thick gallbladder wall, and sludge or fossil stones.
Okay, and what's the normal thickness of the gallbladder wall?
3 millimeters.
Okay. And then if the patient doesn't have stones but has symptoms, then what might they have?
Acalculus, cholecystitis.
All right, and what kinds of patients get acalculus cholecystitis? Let's look at the common bile duct and just measure that, please. Okay, and then you can measure that. And then just tell us what's in you store that. And then what's what would you expect the common bile duct size in a 47-year-old?
4.7 millimeters.
Okay, and then the upper limit of normal
is 6 millimeters if they still
have it. Yeah, and if they don't?
10 millimeters.
Okay. And now do you have any other thoughts on who can get acalculus cholecystitis? Two patient populations that are prone to acalculus cholecystitis.
People who have problems with calcium, like hypercalcemia or hypocalcemia.
Anybody else?
Men.
Okay, that's fine. So now let's so that's all the kind of standard questions. Now I want you to see if you can show me the left renal vein.
Okay.